Folks, this is a quick demonstration of how I set up my stack dado. This is for my Shopsmith. It's going to be similar for other saws and tools. Let's look at the different parts here. First of all, you have two outside blades. These are the cutter blades. And pay attention to the rotation on those, which way they go. These are two flat washers. You want to make sure the little rabbet inside goes to the inside up against the blades. And this is a locking washer. It's very important that's on there. That keeps everything tight and secure so it doesn't move. And then here you have a spacer. Most dado sets will have different spacers for getting your fine tuning and adjustment. This is your locking nut. It's very important that that's on snug and that you have at least two threads showing when you tighten that down. Then you have the chippers that you see there in the middle. First thing I do is put on the washer with the rabbet facing up. In this case, I'm going to take one of the outside cutters and put that in place. Again, you see the way the rotation is going there, so when it's on the saw, the cut will be towards me. And then the chipper blades here, I want to make sure that the teeth are not touching the teeth of the other first blade on there, so I always position those chipper teeth so there's no pressure on that, and it's going to give me an accurate read. So each one that I set, I just make sure it's not touching any other tooth. And we just put in the number. What I do on this to get the spacing right, I'm going to give it an estimate, first of all. And I know on this setup that I want to do here, this is going to be pretty close. And then I might want to add a spacer in like this. If you're going to add more than one spacer, don't add them all at the same place. Kind of stagger them between your chippers. And that'll just give you a better result. And then I put on the outside blade again, making sure that that doesn't touch any of the teeth of the chipper. Put on the big washer and then put on the washer with the a little tooth on it. Then finally the nut. This, unlike your Shopsmith blades, your normal Shopsmith blades, these tighten on clockwise just as the way that you would think that they would. And I'm using my bench here to lay this on. What I'm doing is setting this down into the little gap there, and I want to make sure that's all the way down flat on the table. You'll see why that is. There we go. Now it's down flat. The reason for that is now I can take a scrap piece of the wood that I'll be working with. This is, in this case, it's plywood. They call it 3/4 inch, but it may or may not be. And I'll just lay it right there next to the tooth and use my finger. You know, your fingers are much more sensitive than your eyes if you're a normal human being. They say you can detect a thousandth of an inch. I'm not sure what that really is, but we'll just go ahead and clamp it into the bench here and tighten it down with the wrenches. If you don't have these wrenches, you can use open-end wrenches or whatever. Just make sure it fits snugly so it doesn't slip and ding your fingers on this. This tightens clockwise just as you would expect, but it's not the way that the normal Shopsmith saw arbor tightens down. So you go clockwise, get it snug, and then I like to give it a little extra because we want to make sure that's on there nice and snug. You don't have to get crazy with it, but that's really all there is to it right there. You could go ahead and mount it into the Shopsmith with the machine unplugged and tighten it there. That works pretty well too. Once I tighten it, I like to check it again, because when you do tighten it, obviously it's going to possibly vary a little bit. And I like to go all the way around because sometimes these teeth are not exactly the same size. It's unfortunate, but they won't be as accurate as maybe you want them to be. So I go all the way around, check it with that, and I should be good to go. Then I'll make a test cut just to be sure that everything is where I want it to be. And here is an example of a dado that I made using this setup, and it's a pretty good fit. I could have perhaps made that just a touch tighter, but on a joint like this, it's going to be definitely strong enough. I don't have to worry about it. And also, I'm going to put some kind of a face frame or a trim piece on the front of that so that won't show. So I get both the strength and the looks that I want. So that's really about all there is to it. If you don't have those particular wrenches, guys, you can use any adjustable wrenches or whatever you have around. Just make sure that they fit well so they don't slip off of there. And that's about all there is to it. I'm going to go ahead and mount the dado onto the Shopsmith. Now I'm using the new PowerPro, and this is the first time I've used it, the dado, since I got the PowerPro. But I was really amazed at how well this cut. That's a pretty hefty dado. I'm cutting about 5/8 of an inch deep and about 3/4 wide, and that just powered right through it without any problem whatsoever. So again, the PowerPro is just a much nicer tool to work with. gives you that extra heft. Now guys, I don't recommend you take that deep of a cut. I just wanted to see how it would work. Usually in something like that, you're better off to do it in two different passes. But does a beautiful job. It's smooth, it's nice, and you know, it used to be, it seemed to me like I would have a rougher cut with my dados, and I don't know why the PowerPro would make a smoother cut, but it seems to. And as always, folks, if you like this video, please hit the like button. If you have a question, go in the comment bar, and please subscribe. Thanks.